Good morning. How is everyone doing today? I have to sneeze. Hold on. Goodness. Okay. Back to my ink exploration of June 2023. So today will be ink number 6. So before we move on to that, let's talk about ink number 5, which was Wearing Goals Alice. It was my first shimmer ink that I used in my Texas Wildflowers custom pen from the Taylor Pen Company. And I was very happy with the performance in that pen, honestly, which the pen does have a Yovo nib unit, a number 6 nib. I do have it apart. If from my understanding, please correct me if I am wrong, but as far as Yovo nibs are concerned, it comes in this unit together. The nib and the feed do not separate, I don't think. I do take some extra steps in cleaning my pens whenever I use more high maintenance inks. For one, I use a Goulet pen flush, some brass strips, a very soft toothbrush, and one of these doohickeys. So before we move on to ink number 6, let's talk about how the pen looked. Oh, that's the one. You know what? Let's move this. So we're a few pages through. I can mark the next. So here is ink number 5, Wearing Goals Alice. And then obviously when you first fill that pen up, the ink is just flowing out of the nib. So it does take a minute to see what the ink actually looks like in the pen. And the more that I thought about it, I mean, on a regular basis, who am I writing for? I'm writing for myself, and I'm trying to use my journal for myself. And it's really great when the ink lays down and you get that nice look to show people what the ink looks like. For instance, like at the very top, ink number 5, there's so much shimmer in that. And that shimmer is not consistent all the way down the page. But is there still shimmer as I look at this? Yes. Some spots there's more of it, some spots there's not, but does that bother me? I don't think so. Did I have a lot of pen clogging issues that interrupted the writing? No, I didn't. And then also I noticed while I was writing that whenever I shook the pen to get the shimmer distributed throughout all of the ink, it wasn't interrupted. It was very smooth. Like usually I did it whenever I was thinking about what to write next. So it really wasn't a nuisance for me to use the shimmer ink. And then also I still like the way it looks, even though it's not that bam shimmer at the beginning. I think the shade of Alice matches the pen more than Ferris Wheel Press Dusk and Bloom. So now off to ink number 6. And I have chosen Van Diemen's Seashell from their Underwater collection. A few months ago, I had quite a Van Diemen's ink haul. I purchased directly from them, and it really was a good experience ordering directly from their website. And then also because I think the reason why I ordered from their website is because I wanted to try the Birds of a Feather collection, and they didn't have ink samples available yet in the US stores that I usually order from. And then once I bought those and they were so great, I ended up buying a lot more. So anyway, now I will say that the first time that I tried this ink, it was a sample from Van Ness, and it was a more pale orange. And you guys will see before I swatch this that this is not a pale type orange. Or I feel like the first sample looked like the sun when it glistens on sand, wet sand, just washed from waves. And the glistening that happens on the water, that's the feeling that I got from the first sample. And this one's just not like that. I don't know if, I know that they reformulated some of their shimmer inks to make them more user-friendly in fountain pens. So I don't know if they changed the color of it. I don't know if something was wrong with the Van Ness sample. I really don't know. So we will see how this goes, and then also what you guys think. And then has anyone else had that experience with Seashell? Again, this is an ink that I don't really see a lot of people talk about. So let's get ready. I have my little container here. All right, again, I'm like terrified of the shimmer settling down at the bottom. Get back to the original page before the shimmer settles. Okay, let's do an orange ink. So do you see how bright that is? The first time that I had this ink, it was not like that at all. And I'm still gonna try this ink because it's an orange that I think matches pretty well. Let's ink up this baby. All right, here we go. So Van Diemen's Seashell. Okay, okay. Well, that's fun. My sweet little samples. They went from being so uniform to not. But that's okay. I got plenty of room. All right. That's a very nice, and I don't have an orange shimmer. So this, well, there's one more ink that I'm going to put in this pen, but it's not really orange like this. This is the true orange, the only true orange shimmer that I own. Oh, I forgot to write ink number 6. Probably need to get a replacement cartridge or refill for my other Retro 51 pen. It's a little dry in comparison to this one. So, okay. So, I'm watching this dry and there's some really nice colors coming through that are a part of this pen. Wow. That's a really nice... That's a really nice match. And there's these dark spots that are showing up that are similar to the color of the dark spots in the Indian paintbrush color. So, yay. I am going to wait for it to dry before I start writing. All right, so ladies and gents, what do you think of this ink? Tell me what you think.